Annyeong, pianist Jiyoung Kim here. This is a channel all about classical music. It's beauty and joy and for inspiration for you. So back when was that? In February, when I started to shift all of my in-person piano lessons to online, I actually had a lot of reservation about online piano lessons, you know, just because I have taught and also receive instruction in person in my entire life, right? Playing through and playing at the same time and maybe be able to touch students' shoulder and kind of give some sensation of how they shoot their fingers. And the listening in the real acoustic and be able to detect very little sensitive things. But obviously, we had to switch to everything online. And I have found there are some things that are really cool. So for example, I have conducted this group class. So all of my students gather together for 30 minutes. So I called it as Let's Practice in Your Home Together. So what we did was that before we start that 30-minute session, we share the goal of that 30 minutes. And then I put them in the breakout room on Zoom, so they don't see others. They're basically in their own room practicing. But I, as an instructor, can go in and out each student's practice room, per se. And then I observe as a teacher. I found that it's really fun to sneak up on them to see how they're doing. And I discovered that their way of practicing piano could be better. So when I notice some things, I quietly listen and watch. And if I feel like, yeah, why don't we work on that section a little differently? And I give some practice tips. And they always surprise my presence because, you know, I always put the silence and they don't know I'm coming in or not. So then I give them some tips and I go on to the next person. And then I just go making a little route for 30 minutes. And then after the 30 minutes, everybody back in the main room. And then we talked about what went well, what didn't go well, did they accomplish what they intend to do for that 30 minutes, and kind of share a little bit of feedback and their plan for the week. All my students kind of mentioned that this was one of the most effective piano practice ever in their life, just because everyone else is practicing at the same time at the 30 minutes. Also the fact that I actually observing them and they don't know when I'm coming in. So it was really interesting experience for them. And I encouraged them to do that segment on their own, even though when we don't do it together. I kind of envy my students having that experience. You know, I never had my teacher observe my lesson, but back in high school, I had practice coach, which is kind of the similar idea. She and I sat together for an hour and a half together, and we did some things, work through it together, which was not my main teacher. I know the benefit of practicing very intensively and with somebody, you know? So the fact that I can actually see my students' environment, which I never knew, I also learned a lot of their pets too. It's like they were pets walking around like, oh, you have a cat. Oh, you have a little dog there. I love that part too. But by the way, anyway, so I think be able to see my students' environment is actually very much of good information for me. And even if when we go back to in-person instruction, I think this will be a very valuable, and I hope to continue this 30 minutes practice together session even when we go back. Another thing I found really helpful through this online teaching is that the students get more used to watch themselves. I mean, before that, they were like recording or even in a little camera, they were like freeze up, right? But after watching themselves, or actually kind of to be able to record themselves more often than not nowadays, they are a little bit more less judgmental about watching themselves playing, which is very critical for the growth. I also remember the first time I watched myself on the video, I was so surprised that, oh, I didn't know I had that habit. You know, also my posture was a little more like a hunched down, which I really did not like. And ever since I watched my first video, I corrected immediately because I did not like what I saw. Also, a lot of times when I listened to myself, and more in the back then, there was a huge gap between what I thought I was making and actual reality that I'm making. So I did not like that, to live in the fantasy. So I started to listen to myself a little bit more. And now when I listen to it, it is very close. I mean, there are still things that I would like to adjust after watching or listening, but the gap is much smaller, so that, you know, what I hear while I play is actually reality that I'm producing. But a lot of times I find the students have a huge gap, and I think it is important to, you know, you narrow that gap as you move forward. That is also very good benefit doing it online shift. Another benefit I find is that be able to record the lesson. Not all my students do that, but when you do, you have this record of lesson and you can go back. Not that you can't record your in-person lesson. In fact, I always recorded my lesson, audio record, and listen to it a lot. But through Zoom lesson, I think there is even added version of visualness. You know, I wish sometimes I could have that video record of my lesson with my teachers in the past. It will be really, I don't know, very nice to watch it again. Because at the moment, a lot of times during the lesson, I find it felt like a magic is taking place. That I can't really pinpoint what that was unless I was in it. And when I always look back and listen back, and that magic was still there. A lot of times when lesson taking place, there's a lot of new information is coming as a student. When you actually review it afterwards, you find the things that, oh, that's what she meant during the lesson, I didn't get it, or the things that you completely missed. The fact that it's already there in the video, it's just a matter of a push a button. I think it is very beneficial for you to start record your lessons. Of course, you will have to ask your teacher permission to do that and use it for your own private uses. But I bet most of teachers would not mind that. Especially, you know, all of the things that you cover during the lesson would be improved afterwards. You know, at this point, I kind of find that online lessons are not far, far from in-person lessons. Of course, I would always choose in-person lesson, but at this point, I actually find that the transition was quite seamless, and be able to give instruction that I would like to give a given a student or the piece of music. Obviously, one of the benefits is the safety at this time, and you can be in your home and still continue piano lessons. And the fact that you can have a piano instructor who may not have to be in your hometown. That's a huge benefit. Although all my students are still a local. But I do see that that can happen, you know. Of course, I did not talk about technical aspect of online lessons, like where your computer is positioned or what kind of microphone that I recommend for students to have, you know, things like that. If you are interested in how my setup is around the piano for teaching or performances, I create this video sharing my environment. So if you have any experience of teaching online or receiving on piano lessons, or record yourself, please share it with me in what way it impacted you in a positive way. So looking forward to hearing from you. Have fun creating music this week. Practice efficiently. 안녕.